What is going on, YouTube world? Back with another great video for you guys today. Be sure to like the video right now if you're rocking with your boys. Subscribe to the channel if you're new as well. I do post a ton of great sports videos like this weekly, almost every single day if I can. All right, Clemson Tigers football schedule. I'm previewing and breaking down the defending national champions football schedule, the Clemson Tigers. I'll go game by game, try to see where I can find some wins and losses in 2019 for this Clemson Tigers football team. I'll tell you where I think they'll win games, where they'll lose games, or if they'll win it, or if they'll lose any games at all. I mean, Clemson's a stacked team. I mean, they went 15-0 last year. One of the greatest teams ever, in my opinion. They're in that conversation. I mean, anytime you go 15-0 and smack Notre Dame and Alabama in the college football playoffs, you're in that discussion, in my opinion, okay? Now, they obviously had some struggles early on in the season this past year, but after struggling with Texas A&M and Syracuse, where they won both those games barely, they absolutely annihilated everyone else down the stretch. I mean, it wasn't even close. They never looked back. They beat Notre Dame 30-3 in the college football playoffs. They also beat Alabama 44-16 in the national championship game.
I don't want to hear any more Alabama fans say, oh, Tua should have been the Heisman Trophy winner, man. Oh, they all these common college football fans saying, oh, the SEC, man, it's so dominant. Look, it's the best conference, yes, but are these teams beatable? Yes! They look like a high school football team in the second half versus Clemson. Trevor Lawrence.
Now, I personally picked Clemson to win that game, but I never in a million years thought Alabama would curb stomp, beat down so daggone badly. I was so happy Clemson won that game so bad. I'm not a Clemson fan at all. I'm an Ohio State fan, but I hate Alabama. I always love Alabama getting smacked, so thank you, Taters, for doing that. But either way, let's get to some things. Obviously, you do lose Clelin Ferrell this year. You lose Christian Wilkins. You lose Dexter Lawrence. You lose Austin Bryant. You lose Hunter Renfrow. You lose Trayvon Mullen. So some key players you lose this year. Obviously, pretty much your whole defensive line. I mean, that whole defensive line pretty much got drafted. I mean, Clelin Ferrell, Dexter Lawrence, and Christian Wilkins all went in the first round. Okay. You return 8 players on offense, though, but only 4 on defense. But I'm going to tell you right now, as far as defense goes, I think Clemson's going to be fine. Obviously, they might take a slight step back this year just because those players were so good. But Clemson's recruited at an insanely high level this past couple years, okay? Obviously, you got players like Xavier Thomas, Justin Foster, Jordan Williams, KJ Henry waiting to play. I mean, they have a ton. They're pretty much like Alabama, Ohio State, whatever, any top program, LSU. Whatever players they lose, they return with pretty much the same talent the next year. It's all through recruiting, guys. They have a ton of NFL players waiting to play on that roster. Now, obviously, you bring back Travis Etienne, who had 24 touchdowns this past year. To me, he's the best running back in college football. I understand Jonathan Taylor has something to say about that, but I think Travis Etienne, for my money, is the best running back in college football. You bring back Trevor Lawrence in his second year. Some people are already saying he's going to be the next Andrew Luck. I mean, the guy is special. To me, he's the best quarterback in all of college football, in my opinion, okay? You got Justin Ross. You got T. Higgins to throw to. You also return Isaiah Simmons, a stud linebacker / safety. So Clemson's loaded again. Let's see how many games they can win on their schedule. Let's jump right into the schedule. The first 3 games of the season. Well, let's go over the first. Yeah, let's go over the first 3 games. Georgia Tech at home. Texas A&M at home. At Syracuse. I think you start 3-0. Now, this to me is the toughest stretch of games for Clemson. If they're going to lose games, I think they're going to lose one of these couple games here, or maybe 2 of these games here, okay? Georgia Tech at home, you'll easily win that game. Texas A&M, not a pushover game. Texas A&M almost beat you last year. They came back. They came roaring back. The game almost went to overtime. They could have stole it. You could have lost that game. You barely won that game. I get it, but to me, Clemson's the better team. And Clemson, you know, it was early in the season where Clemson was struggling a little bit. But let's be real, after Clemson got over those early season struggles last year, whatever they were doing, whatever they weren't executing, whatever they weren't doing as far as blowing teams out and playing down the competition, Clemson was by far, they were obliterating teams. So I think Clemson gets back on track this year. They start off a little bit faster this year. Trevor Lawrence to open up the playbook a little bit more for him. I do think that Jimbo Fisher and this Texas A&M team is very good, but I think they're about a year away. I think you beat them at home. You're a better team. You get them at home this year. If it was in Texas A&M, I might pick A&M to win, but it's at Clemson. I can't see you losing at Clemson, in Clemson this year to them. You'll win that game at Syracuse. They've had your number over the past couple years. I mean, obviously beating you when they were a terrible team in 2017, 27-24. Last year, the game came down to the wire. It was 27-23. You barely won that game at home. Trevor Lawrence goes down that game. I believe it was Chase Bryce who came in and relieved for you guys, saved your butt. Okay. But, I mean, Syracuse returns 8 on offense, 5 on defense. But they do lose Eric Dungy, Jamal Custis. Okay. Clemson, to me, is a better team. I understand you had to go into Syracuse and play them, but I just think Clemson's the better team. You'll roll in that game. You'll win that game. Okay. The next couple games. I will go over the next 4 games for you. You play Charlotte at home. You're at UNC. You play Florida State. And you play at Louisville, okay? You're going to be 4-0 in those stretch of games. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. You'll be 7-0 after these couple games, okay? Listen. Charlotte, to me, who are they? They're not a good team. They don't have the talent to beat Clemson. You'll win that game easily. UNC, every now and then they turn around and are a decent team, but let's be real, that's a basketball school. No one cares about football here. They're not a good team. You'll win that game easily, okay? Florida State at home, that's obviously a rivalry game. You curve stomped them. You beat them down. I mean, I've never seen Florida State get beat so badly. I've never seen Florida State get beat so badly last year. Now, I do think Florida State has talent on their roster. I mean, Cam Akers is a very good running back. They recruited very well, and they had the talent on their roster. But for whatever reason, they're pretty much like USC. The talent they have doesn't translate to any wins. They don't win games. They do less with more, okay? Florida State's offensive line is terrible. Alex Hornibrook doesn't know what's going to come for him this year. Clemson's the better team. They're going to win this game. I could see you potentially maybe losing this game, but at the same time, I don't. You're going to win that game easily. Louisville at home. I mean, the only reason Louisville has a chance to win this game is because it's being played at Louisville. There's no shot Louisville wins this game. You'll easily, and I mean easily, roll through this game. I mean, Clemson, to me, might be the best team in college football next year. All levels of football. Defensive line, offensive line, quarterback, running back, wide receiver. They're pretty much better than every team in every category. Maybe except Alabama, Ohio State, or Georgia, okay? All right, up next, I'm going to go over the next couple games on your schedule. I'm just going to end your schedule right here. Boston College at home, Wofford at NC State, Wake Forest, and at South Carolina. Undefeated season for Clemson, okay? Undefeated season, okay? I just don't see, look, this schedule to me, other than the Texas A&M game, is a joke. It's a joke. There's no one on the schedule that can challenge you. The ACC is at an all-time low, and Clemson's at an all-time high. I just can't see any team beating this team anywhere on the schedule. I just can't. I can't drop a scenario where Syracuse wins. I can't drop a scenario where I see Texas A&M win a game. I can't see a scenario where South Carolina wins a game. I can't see a scenario where NC State wins a game. I'll just go over these couple games. Boston College is never a terrible team, but let's be real. You beat them in their place last year. You'll beat them again this year. Wofford, stop. They're not a good team. At NC State, you struggle a little bit with them historically, but they do lose Ryan Finley, their quarterback from last year. They do lose Kevin Harmon. You blew them out at your place this past year. There's no reason you can't win by more double digits this year. You'll win that game pretty easily. At South Carolina, it's a little bit tricky. I get that Jake Bentley did throw for 510 yards versus you guys last year, but I think that was an aberration. I don't think it happens again. They do lose Deebo Samuel, who's a big part of that passage outing that Jake Bentley had last year. And, you know, Clemson, they still put up 56 points versus you guys last year, South Carolina. So, the only reason why South Carolina has a chance to me is because it's played at South Carolina. Kind of potentially see you being not focused and losing a game, yes. But at the same time, no. So, without further ado, that's the end of this schedule. Clemson, to me, is the best team on paper in college football. I'm not predicting they're going to win a national title. Okay, I'm not saying that right now. I'll get to those predictions later in the year. But just on paper, best quarterback in football, in college football. Best running back in college football, in my opinion. A top 4 wide receiver core in college football, in my opinion. A top 4 offensive line core in college football. One of the better D-lines as far as talent goes. I understand you lose some great players, but the talent Clemson will roll out on that field is going to be second to none. Okay, secondary, pretty decent. Linebacker core, pretty good. Clemson, to me, is just at an all-time high. I mean, they're building potentially a dynasty. Dabo Sweeney's one of the best coaches in all of college football. I just don't see any team challenging Clemson. They don't play any tough road opponents, in my opinion. And like I said, if you were to bet money, if you were to tell me what team, if you were to try to shoot me in my head and say, man, what team is guaranteed to make the playoffs next year? it's going to be Clemson because the ACC is terrible, their schedule's terrible, and they're just overall superiorly better than everyone they will be playing this year. They're the best team in college football, in my opinion. They're better than Alabama. They're a better team than my Buckeyes. They're better than Georgia. They're better than Oklahoma. Now, I'm not saying that these teams have a chance that Clemson can't be knocked off. I'm not saying that at all. But if I had to bet money, Clemson easily wins the ACC, and they easily get back to the college football playoffs. That's a wrap for this video. Be sure to like the video right now if you're rocking with your boy. Subscribe to the channel if you're new as well. I do post a ton of great sports videos like this weekly, and almost every single day if I can. It's my favorite thing in the world to do to make these YouTube videos for you guys. I appreciate you guys. I love you guys. Thank you for tuning in all the time, guys. I appreciate you guys. My favorite thing in the world to do. Be sure to help this channel grow. Share this channel with your friends on Facebook. Share it on Twitter. Share it on Instagram. Share it wherever, okay? I just want this channel to grow. I want to become a sports analyst when I get older. I want to become one of the next Skip Baylesses. I want to become one of the next Shannon Sharps. I want to become one of the next Stephen A. Smiths. I want to become one of the next Colin Cowherds, okay? So just please help this channel grow. I appreciate you guys for tuning in today. It's my favorite thing in the world to do is make these YouTube videos for you guys. Help me achieve my dreams. I don't make content for views, guys. I make it because I love to do it. I have a passion for it. It's been your boy, Jemima McKinney. God bless, and I'm out.